Triprangode Lord Shiva Temple is located at Triprangode, Kerala. It is one of the most important Hindu pilgrimage centers in northern Kerala. Kokila Sandeśa of Uddanta Sanstrikal mentions Triprangode among other major destinations in the region. Inscriptions of the later Chera ruler Goda Ravi Varma were discovered from the Triprangode Shiva Temple. Later, the region formed a part of the Kingdom of Tanur Vettathunad, who were the vassals of the Zamorins of Calicut. The main army led by the Zamorin camped at Triprangode during the Thirunavaya Wars of the 14th century. Long ago, Sage Mrikandu with his wife Marudvati both were devotees of Shiva. He is the eternal lord and ruler of time, Mahakaleshwara, the originator of time and destroyer of time, or Kala Samhara Murti. The couple were childless and so decided to perform austerity rituals so they would be blessed with a child. Then one day, Shiva appeared before them. Shiva asked the couple if they desired an ordinary and mentally disabled son who would live a long life, or an exceptional son who would live a short life up until the age of 16. The couple chose the second kind. In due course, Marudvati gave birth to a boy and the child was named Markandeya. Markandeya was an exceptionally gifted child and became an accomplished sage early in his childhood. He was especially devoted to Shiva and had mastered the Mahamrityunjaya mantra. As the boy was getting on to be 16, Rishi Mrikandu and his wife became sad. Noticing this, Markandeya inquired about their sadness and they replied that at the age of 16, his time on this earth will come to an end, and so Yama came to take his life away. The boy Markandeya then ran to Lord Mahavishnu, but he was helpless and he directed him to Triprangotappan, Lord Shiva. On the way to Triprangode temple, there was a huge banyan tree that stood by making difficulty to enter into the temple. At the time he reached there, surprisingly, the tree separated into two parts and then he could easily enter into temple. Markandeya hugged the Shiva Lingam and requested Lord Shiva to protect him from Yama. Yama threw his noose around the boy's age. It encircled the Shiva Lingam too. At a blow, the Shivalingam burst open with a thundering roar and a majestic, fiery form of Lord Shiva appeared out of the blazing light. Lord Shiva was very angry and asked whether Yama has this much courage to encircle the Shivalingam with his noose. Shiva struck down Yama with his trident and Yama was no more. Markandeya was escaped from death. Shiva blessed Markandeya with eternal life and proclaimed that he shall remain forever as a 16-year-old sage. The assembly of Devas who had witnessed all these begged Shiva to revive Yama. Otherwise, there will be a situation in the world with people live long without death. This would put unnecessary burden on the earth. Shiva then revived Yama and declared that his devotees were forever to be spared from the noose of Yama. Since that day, the fiery form of Shiva that appeared to save the boy sage Markandeya is called Kala Samhara Murti. The main idol is the swayambhoolingam of Lord Shiva facing west. There is a shrine dedicated to Goddess Parvati towards the left side of Lord Shiva. There are four more shrines dedicated to Lord Shiva in the temple complex. One is considered as the moolasthanam, that means the original seat of the Lord. It is called Karanail temple. The other three shrines represent the three steps taken by the Lord to kill Yama. Om Namah Shivaya.